Welcome to 2024, and this is Honest Wedding Advice with DJ ESG. I've been in the private event industry for 30 plus years. Over 3,500 events, weddings, sweet 16s, mitzvahs, you name it, I've done it. And this is the most honest, truthful, straight to the point wedding advice podcast you will find anywhere. There's no froofiness, there's no sugarcoating. I tell you how it is all the time. Take it or leave it. I'd rather give you the honest advice than give you some bullshit blowing smoke up your ass. But I'll tell you this, it's short, it's quick, it's to the point, and you will learn something. I'm DJ ESG, the EST of ECEG. Check out the podcast. You will not be disappointed. What's up, guys? DJ ESG, one day before Thanksgiving, Honest Wedding Advice, season number 5. Happy Thanksgiving to you and your family. And today I'm talking about shit never to say to a DJ. I mean, these are just bonehead things that people say to me or to my colleagues at events that I literally just want to hang myself every time I hear it. I mean, it is so fucking stupid and so fucking dumb. And I understand that sometimes alcohol is involved, but you'd be surprised how many times sober people ask me for this bullshit. I got a list. I'm just going to browse through it real quick, pull out a couple ones that I know, just grind my fucking gears. I'm going to Peter Griffin this shit right now. So hopefully you can understand where I'm coming from. All right, play something good, something we can dance to. A whole packed floor of people, and here comes some random person. Can you play something else? I don't like this song. Well, let me tell you something. The whole rest of the dance floor loves what I'm playing. They're having a good time. They're dancing to it. Unless you're the bride or the groom, get out of my grill. And then 5 minutes later, the fiance or the boyfriend comes up. Dude, I heard what she just said. You're standing next to each other. I knew you were going to come up and say that. Tell her I said no. And if I can do it, I'll do it later. Chill out. Then they give you this like mean face. You're like, you're dancing. You're having a good time. Shut up because you didn't get your way. If you were supposed to get your way, you'd be a bridesmaid or a groomsman. You're not. You're a guest. Pay your $100, eat your fucking salmon, go keep dancing. Next, would you play something with a beat? Every fucking song has a beat. I mean, every song has a beat. There's no song that doesn't have a beat. Acapellas don't have it. Who's playing a fucking acapella? Play a song with a beat. Of course it has a beat. Every song has a drum line, a bass line, a rhythm line. That's like saying, give me french fries that are potato. No, give me fucking cauliflower once. Stupid idiot. Yeah, it's got a beat. Come over there and dance. Another one of my favorites. I don't know who sings it. I don't know the name of the song, but it goes like this. And then they start humming it in front of me. Dude, I don't know. Figure it out and come back. Go take your phone, Google it, Spotify it, Shazam it, do something. Once you know what you're talking about, come back to me. It's like when people look up to me and they say, can you play Apple Bottom Jeans? I mean, like Low by Flo Rida? Yeah, that's the one. Play that one. Man, you don't know what the name of that fucking song is by now? That song's been out for like 15 years. It's one of the most popular. You don't know that song's called Low? That's like me watching that show with the 6 people in the apartment and not knowing it's called Friends. I mean, come on, man. Figure that shit out. Or this one. Everybody wants to hear this. Did you poll the room? Like, did you walk around the room and ask everybody who was there if they wanted to hear this particular song? Man, if you were able to do that and poll the entire room and everybody wants to hear this song, man, you're amazing. You are the most incredible wedding guest ever. You were able to poll the room. Politicians can't even poll their block and you're gonna poll the room? Dude, you're amazing. Absolutely incredible. I want to hear it next. That's great. I want to win the lottery. That doesn't necessarily mean you're getting it next. It might not work with what I'm doing. It might not work with anything. It might not work for me, the bride, or the groom. I'll play it when I get to it, if I get to it. Go back over there and keep dancing. And stop dropping your drink and breaking glass everywhere. You're killing me. One of my favorites, people walk up to me behind the DJ booth and goes, what do you have in there? Well, I have a computer with over 1 million songs. That's what I have in there. I have tons of music. Well, can I see? No, you can't see. What the fuck do you want me to play? Tell me. There's a million songs in there. Don't ask me what I have. I can get it all. I have everything. Ask me what I don't have. Nothing. I don't have nothing. My wife would tell me that's ass backwards the way I said that. I don't have anything. I don't have nothing. I can get it all. All you need to know. Or another one of my favorites. Hey, dude, nobody can dance to this while the whole dance floor is dancing. I had a woman walk up to me one time. She said, nobody's dancing to this. So I just looked at her and I just gazed on the dance floor. And she kind of followed my eyes and the dance floor was packed. And I said, who's not dancing to this? She goes, I'm the aunt of the bride. She goes, I need something else. This doesn't work for me. I go, well, it works for 95% of the people here. So if I'm going to play a song that only works for you and doesn't work for anybody. Oh, wait, stop. You're the aunt of the bride? Are you her dad's sister or her mom's sister? Dad's. Honey, your brother's out there dancing right now. He's actually half topless. So clearly it works for him. Thank you. Bring me a donut. Or my absolute favorite. My favorite. Can you play it soon because we're leaving? Well, that's your problem. Don't leave. What are you leaving for? Seriously. You're at a wedding. You're not the bride. You're not the groom. Just leave me alone or leave the DJ alone. Alcohol does some weird shit. Hey, instead of complaining to me, go over there and complain to your fiance or your spouse. Or better yet, go get yourself sexually prepared for a late night tonight. Because it's date night and you're having a good time and you look good and you're dressed well. You're going to go back to the hotel room or back home. You're going to say, honey, I'm going to get me some tonight. Yeah, yar. So stop worrying about what I'm playing and worrying about that. Jesus Christ. People are nuts. All of you are fucking batshit crazy. Oh my God, I need a Xanax. I'm ESG. Peace, love, and God above. It's great advice. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Do you
you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once. I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck? I went to a shrink to analyze my dreams. She says it's like I'm sex, that's bringing me down. I went to a whore. He said my life's a bore. Choke with my wife and puss, it's bringing her down. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my it all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up.